Unit 10, the present continuous tense. The present continuous tense is used to show the action or the event is happening at the moment of speaking. For example, you are drinking the Coca-Cola, so you are holding the glass, a glass of Coca-Cola, and then you must perform the action or drink at the moment of speaking. Slide 2. The present continuous positive. The formula is subject be is MR plus verb ing object. The subject I, the verb to be should be am plus verb ing sing become singing and the object is a song. You are the subject. You is the subject. The verb to be for you should be are, and the verb ing for sing becomes singing, the object is a song. Then for the third person singular, the verb to be should be is. Then the sing, we transform it into ing form becomes sing, the object is a song. Then after the third person singular, the fourth person plural, we, you, they. The verb to be for the plural subject should be are. Then for the verb singing, we transform it to be verb ing form become singing. As usual, as before, a song is the object. So, I am singing a song, you are singing a song, he is singing a song, she is singing a song, it is singing a song, we are singing a song, you are singing a song, they are singing a song. Slide 3. Present continuous negative. The formula is subject, verb to be is MR plus not plus verb ing plus object. I am not singing a song. Just now I have explained the present continuous positive. But for present continuous negative, we just put not, we sandwich the negator not between the verb to be and verb ing. Once again, to form the present continuous negative, we just sandwich or put into the middle or insert the negator not between verb to be and verb ing form. I am not singing a song. You are not singing a song. He is not singing a song. She is not singing a song. It is not singing a song. We are not singing a song. You are not singing a song. They are not singing a song. Slide 4. The present continuous interrogative. For the interrogative present continuous, we put the verb to be in the first position, then followed by the subject, followed by the verb ing, and the last is followed by the object. Let's see more example in the sentences. Am is part of verb to be. I is the subject. Singing come from the verb sing. We transform it into singing by putting ing after sing. A song is the object. R is verb to be. U is the subject. Singing come from the verb sing. A song is the object. Is verb to be. He is the subject. Singing come from the verb sing. A song is the object. Is verb to be. She is the subject. Singing come from the verb sing. A song is the object. Is verb to be. It is the subject. Singing come from the verb sing. A song is the object. Are is verb to be. We is the subject. Singing come from the verb sing. A song is the object. All come from the verb to be. You is the subject. You here are plural. The second you is a singular one. You the only one. Kamu. But for you after the subject we are the plural one. You hear all of you. Kalian semua, more than one. Singing come from the verb sing. A song is the object. Are is verb to be. They is the subject. Singing come from the verb sing. A song is the object. So am I singing a song? Are you singing a song? Is he singing a song? Is she singing a song? Is it singing a song? Are we singing a song? Are you singing a song? Are they singing a song?